Okay, I want to do a little video here and talk about these different cans that you find bully beef in, the different places they come from, different factories, and little differences. It's something that, I don't know, if you're leery about soldered cans, it might be something to look at. Notice with the small Mario brand corned beef cans that they have a soldered seam. So I start looking at them and seeing what. At the time, I was thinking, I was like, they don't still solder cans together, do they? Like, unless it's like leadless solder or something, I don't know. But it's sort of, probably just is lead solder, but I'm not really sure. But so I looked it up, and it, according to the interwebs, it was like 1995 or something that the FDA in the States banned like the use of lead, I guess, in food cans. And then they banned like the importation, I guess, of food that was soldered together, like had soldered seams or whatever. But so I found that kind of interesting. I was fairly, it's not that long, many years ago, but I guess around the world they still do it. Like there's a lot of metal containers you can buy that have non-food things in them that are soldered together. Like some, I think like white gas, like Coleman fuel and stuff. I think the screw cap part is soldered in, and the handle and stuff like that, but you're not eating out of that. So, but so you look at these ones, like these are all from Brazil, and this they're all 226, which I think that corresponds with a factory, but I'm not really sure how that works. But it's something their Ministry of Agriculture, like that was the inspection number or something. But I guess it would correspond with a certain factory. It's hard to see, but the label. But I got one here that was. See, it's the same one, but you can see it actually has a soldered joint. Like they fold it, fold the it over on itself, and then solder it, I guess, to make it airtight. Like the tops and bottoms on. I guess they've been doing like over 100 years, but the way they're crimped together is. Like, there's a lip on the side part, and then the lid comes down and around and then up. And so I'll put it in a picture, show how a double seam or whatever they call it. But which is kind of weird that some of them are still have lead in them, like the or maybe, I don't know. Like there was. This one's 337, which is the same as these Bristol ones, but they're if you look at them, you can see the welded seam right there. But then there was 385. Like these are both Hereford brand. This one's a 385, and you can see where it's got the folded. That'll focus. It's got the folded crimp. It looks to be solder there. It looks like down here anyway. You can see right by the key there. You can see it there. Yeah, there you go. But so I guess your 226s and your 385s are soldered, but then the other Brazilian ones are welded together. So some, maybe some of them still have old canning machines from, you know. From the first war or something, but you can see like this French, like the big Mario one is product of France. You can see where it's welded together. Then most, like this is luncheon meat from, I think it's made by Maple Leaf and Canning. See the weld mark there. Then your spam cans are like they're aluminum, they're just stamped and then the lid's put on. So there's no seam basically other than the one. So all these, like most cans are like basically three piece, I guess you get your top and bottom and then your this part. So, but so anyway, I found that kind of interesting. But I guess it's done well. It can't get into the food, but I'm still kind of wondering if that actually is lead or not. Like it looks like solder, but I don't know. So, Anyway, so maybe just find the, let's see, 337s don't have it. And so, and the French ones don't. So, anyway, kind of interesting. Talk to you later.